Check out channelfireball.com to step up your game with videos and articles from the best in the world. You can use the code Gaby at checkout to help support this channel. Hello, everybody on YouTube, and welcome. We are drafting the Proliferate Cube today. What should we take, Jet? World is our oyster. Could really take anything. We haven't really drafted black, green, or anything like that. So I could see, black, red. So I could see like Steamkin or Butcher. I think one of the better cards is Thrumming Bird. This one's like just unassuming, but does a lot of work. Yeah, I was kind of looking at that. I could also see saying taking Thoughtseize because it's never going to be bad in something like this. Yeah, Destiny, I was thinking, I said I didn't draft BG, but really we've drafted a lot of BG. I just had BG in the mind, you know? Oh, it was a Freudian slip, Squirrel. I've drafted a lot of BG. Dude, Squirrel, I still can't believe that was your first GP. Want to hear a funny story about that GP? So I played, Knight of the Ebon Legion, huh? That sounds better than Marionette Master or pretty much the other stuff I have going on here. The Animating Fairy is interesting, but we have nothing that works with it yet. We could also take Metamorph because it's a colorless card and maybe that's the best pick. I'm kind of leaning towards that too, Time Twister. Yeah, Cremita and Time Twister are on Metamorph. I like that too. So anyway, at that first Grand Prix I ever went to, I played a lot locally, but I'd never played Modern. And so this is back when I liked aggro decks, which is funny because I don't really play like creature decks that much anymore these days. But this is like back when I really liked aggro decks. So I go to my friends and I'm like, hey, what deck should I get for Modern? I want to go to this Grand Prix. They're like, you should get Affinity. Spoiler alert, Affinity's not an aggro deck. But I didn't know that at the time. So I like trade for Affinity cards at my local shop and then eventually buy the rest of the cards that I'm missing from CFB. And it is really not an aggro deck. It's not an aggro deck. What a horrible suggestion. I can't believe my friends like tricked me into it. So after playing Affinity for a while, I'm like, what do you know? This deck is really not for me. Too much. I really did buy from CFB, but Bernie, I've been shopping from CFB from before they sponsored the stream. Without using the code Gaby, which you can use if you want to directly support the stream. Hey, do we just take boppers? I think so. Are we back on the black green plan? Can't help myself. So anyway, oh my god, we're back baby. Jaylight Ranger looks awesome in this deck. We just have to get more good stuff. Like, we're a black-green deck that if we get Winding Constrictor, we're going to be super happy about it. Favorite Halloween candy? Kit Kats. Also M&Ms. Also Reese's. Or Reese's. Reese's. Not Reese's. Reese's. Line of War Reborn is Stealth of Pages like Orin Wraith. Let me look at this. Graft 1. Oh, that's cute. So it enters tab, but it's a +1/+1 counter on it, and then you choose who you want to give it to. I'm going to deliver to you. Yeah, so I'm going to take Jadelight Ranger because I do think this card's really good in this kind of deck. But that card seems very good, Gatekeeper. I'd never even seen it before. Hey, Firefly. Welcome. Hey, Smurfy. Yeah, chat. Favorite Halloween candy? But how do you eat the Kit Kat? I put it in the freezer and then I eat it. I let it get frozen. It makes me so happy. Primal Might. Target chickens +X/+X until on a turn, then fights up to one creature you don't control. I don't think I'm interested in that. If we end up being... So we took a Retribution of the Ancients last time, but if we end up being a more Counters Matters deck, I could see Retribution being good still. No, no worries, Murphy. It's good to see you. Haste and Shadow. You'd Grumgully. Grumgully is good in these kinds of decks. Each non-human creature you control enters the battlefield with an additional +1/+1 counter on it. I could see specking on Grumgully. It's not even clear that we're actually going to be black. Because we have the Thoughtseize, but we're not committed to black by any means. So after all this happens, I decide that Affinity's not for me. So I decide to go get a different deck. I think I like the Long Tusk Cub here or the Bayou. Mr. Horrible. This is a non-human too. It's a cat. It doesn't really look like a cat, but whatever. My immersion. The Vivid Lands aren't bad. Isn't the Long Toss Cup just better? This card is so good if you just play it on turn two and then they can't block it. It's amazing. Do you guys remember this card in Constructed? It was so good. Yeah, Vladiator, that's what I'm saying. This card used to just snowball out of control. Balling out of control. So then, in an effort to... But the GP's coming up, so I don't know what to do because I decided I don't want to play Affinity, but I don't know another Modern deck because they're expensive and I was like pretty new to Magic at the time. So my friend lends me a Boggles deck, so I play some leagues to prep for it. And this was this format where Jund was the most popular and all Jund had was Edict effects, like Mono Liliana controls. I went 0-3, but I had two buys, by the way. So I go 2-3 drop. It was bad. Then I joined side events and then it was more fun. Whenever a creature dies, you may put a quest counter on it, remove 3 quest counters, it gets a 5/5 black zombie. I think I'd rather just take Aether Poisoner because I already have Long Tusk Cub. And I can make servos with this too, so at this point I'm drafting kind of energy. Cub got out hand fancy. Yeah! Enclave Cryptologist. That card is cool. I do like that card. Do we want a Colony Heart Expedition or a Drana? Because it doesn't... I mean, if we want to go Mauler, we would kind of be veering back towards the Jund life. If we go back Drana, we're going back towards the Garbo life. Gooby on GB, I know. Weird how that happened, right? This is also a vampire. It doesn't work with Grumbly. I think I want to take Drana and see if we can be an aggressive deck. Like, just be a lower to the ground. Like, unlike the last deck we drafted, instead of being pod, just being kind of like black-green stompy-ish. You tried to Drana plus Bob Beatdown today? Yeah, I mean, this card actually does it escalates pretty quickly, right? Does Quarantine Field combo with Proliferate? I would need to read the card. I'm not actually sure. Yeah, look, we can be a very aggressive deck. We can take Knight of Ebon Legion. Now we're just like mono aggro control. Yeah, I thought about taking this on the first time around. We got so lucky that it came back. It was a really, really... She's even an anthem herself. Is she? She puts the counters... Oh, that's right. She has first strike, so she hits, puts counters on your creatures, then they hit. Yeah. That card sucked in its standard format. Let's just keep taking the... This is a 2-drop that you can pay with Phyrexian mana. I think we can afford to do that. Is that better than a Putrid Goblin? I did! Zeladonia! So I ended up going with a cleric. I forget the school, but it's the school that cares about... This is a 3-drop, by the way, and this Grimgully is currently on spec. I ended up being the clerics that like interact with undead. Like, I think the character classes that my thing has... Ooh, kind of like a Porcelain Legionnaire here is a nice 2-drop. What's my cleric's name? Lily! All my D&D characters are named after a magic card that's similar. So I think I've had Teza in my previous campaign and Mara in this campaign. Teza was a... What was Teza? Mara was a druid. Teza was a wizard. Who's the bard? Currently, Luis's brother Antonio is the bard. He's very loud. Yeah, for reals, Wolf. I think Grumgully is the imposter. Do you think they can tell? There's a lot of imposters here. Look at this Porcelain Legionnaire, Spine Thopter, Phyrexian Metamorph. Yeah, exactly. He's a good bard. That makes sense, Murphy. We're actually playing again tonight. So we are going to get to keep running it back. We spent like 2 hours yesterday making characters, so we didn't really get to play that much. I used to love this card so much. So, I don't know if BK's here. BK, are you here by any chance? BK taught me so many lessons in Magic with Chronomaton, because BK would play Chronomaton, and like this whole concept of like block and pump was very new to me. So I'd just attack into Chronomaton thinking that it was going to be fine, and then BK would be like, okay, block in response, pay one, tap, put a +1/+1 counter, and it always gets so mad. Lily's the sickest planeswalker. Yeah, so my cleric right now is Lily, before she, because you know, she used to be a cleric before she became a necromancer. I had one more character that had a magic name. Oh my god, Sluvers. Ooh, I like Fatal Push. Okay, so I was having a conversation with BK about this yesterday. He said that the Nissa of Shadowed Thoughts I should have definitely put in my deck. I kind of agree. Will I be using a non-tested cure for the masses if given a chance? Are you talking about coronavirus? I don't think I'm going to do a non-tested. Oh, is it Shadow Bows? Oh, it is Bows. You take Push, Nissa, or Thirst. I could see also doing... Thirst is really good. It also hits Planeswalkers. Maybe this is fine. Maybe it's better than the Nissa. Fate Transfer is surprisingly great. Let me see that card. I haven't seen it at all. Move all counters from target creature. Oh, I don't like the art. Onto another target. I think I'm going to take the Thirst. It's just a cheap removal, which sounds pretty good for this kind of deck. Cranial Plating doesn't really work for us. What is this? Enchant creature fading one. Enchanted creature gets +3/+2. When Phalanx Dementia leaves the battlefield, destroy enchanted creature. The creature can't be regenerated. Oh, so you pump it up for one turn, but then afterwards it stops. I like it, Slubars. I'm so jealous of your Spindrift. We have some here at home, but we're running out. That's true, Wolf. I would be happy if it came back. I could see Hydra's the curve topper. Really don't want to go into fives. Like, I think if we're trying to go stompy, we want to be even lower than that. But I think we can make an exception for you. What does this do? Primordial Hydra enters the battlefield with X +1/+1 counters. And at the beginning of your upkeep, double the number of +1/+1 counters in Primordial Hydra. Has trample as long as it has 10 or more counters on it. Hissing Quagmire is interesting. I really would not like to have a tap land that I can't pay for in this sort of deck. Are you and the brothers Scott Vargas going to go on any cool hikes while they're in town? I don't know. If we do, we have to go to kind of a low-key hike because Naya Babe can't really hike too much. But I think we are probably going to do some... Going to go check out some hikes and parks and stuff like that. Parks are a little better when we've got the babe. Ghoul. I could see Butcher Ghoul. It's a little small. I think I'll take Hissing Quagmire, but not want to pick up any more tap lands. I think that's the play. What is this? Target creature you control gets +2/+2 until the turn. If its power is 2, then it fights target creature. So what do we have? We have a 1/1, a 2/2 that becomes bigger. This enters with a +1/+1 counter on it. That's not a 2/2. That's not a 2. So, I think we still take swipe even though it's a little awkward with our creatures. Grave Karns if I want to splash red. I don't think I'm going to splash red. In fact, I'm going to move the Grumgully. I think it's past its expiration date now. Oh, yeah, Wolf. I just mean I think most of our creatures have higher than 2 power. Like, we could do it with a Spine Thopter, but I think almost everything else just... I mean, this if it breaks, I guess. This works before it actually gets counters. Spike Feeder, huh? Aether Vial, not really for this deck. I think a Feeder is okay. It enters with 2 counters. That means it's good with a Savage Swipe. Also, it can move counters onto other stuffs. Tybalt or Feeder. Yeah, I don't think we're playing red, so I'm going to just take the Feeder here. Taiga. We might take the Taiga on spec. Because there's nothing we really want here. Like, we don't really want the Grolf's Messenger. Actually, Ghostfire Blade is not bad. So it's 2 less if you have a if it targets a colorless creature. But this is a blue creature. It's not devoid. I think I'll take the Taiga on spec in case we get something like a super banging card that we definitely want to play, but I don't think we're... Yeah, Taiga on spec seems okay. I'm actually going to bring out the Taiga here just so that we know we have it. Yeah, this doesn't look like a Ghostfire Blade. If we were playing the Steel Overseer, this would definitely be a Ghostfire Blade deck. I don't think we want anything here, sadly. These all look pretty bad. Take this. Take this. Is my game bugged? Take this. Okay. Stomping Ground Boney G. I do like Nissa, and Nissa also works with... Nissa both gets us another forest and also works with a Savage Swipe, which is nice. Plus, it makes a Shaya later. Like, if it becomes a long game, it is a Planeswalker that can double up later down the line. Yo, Opulent Banana, welcome. Yeah, it does look like red's kind of open. I do think we are firmly black. Hey, Marky, it's good to see you. Why not steal? We have almost nothing that combos with it. We have a couple of artifact creatures, but not that many. It's good to see you, Marky. How are you? Nissa! Have we seen if the black green Nissa is coming back? I don't know if I saw that. Does Julie like her dog's neck? She does. She likes them quite a bit. Hey, it came back. So we could do the Orin Reef Vastwood, but it's another tap land. Plus, I actually think something like this would be pretty good in this deck. I think Nissa's looking a little better than the Orin Reef Vastwood, even though we just saw it be very good in the last deck. It'd be Nissa. Yeah, I agree. So we are on ones, twos, threes, four, five. Yeah, our curve is very, very low. We might even want to get a Rakdos Cackler just to go ham. Since we probably want to play a lot of black. We've got Knight of Ebon Legion and stuff. Steelbane Hydra. It seems like a sideboard card at the very least. We never want Living End. So yeah, we can put that over there. This if we... Wait. What does this do? Emerald Bruiser enters the battlefield tapped. It has menace as long as you control an artifact. That actually seems quite decent in this deck. This is like a baby version of the rock, the pebbles. Yeah, this is a very like low to the ground version of that, right? Serrated Biskellion. Put a -1/-1 counter on Biskellion, a -1 on target creature. Weird. I don't think we want to convoke this giant dude. We're never playing Grawl's Messenger. Yeah, this is just a bunch of sideboard cards, really. We do have one more pack. Is that so? We would like to get duels. At this point, like, if we can take Bayous or anything like that, or, like, Overgrown Tombs. Triskelion's weird cousin, Biskellion. Everybody has a weird cousin. Weird uncle or aunt. Yeah, no, I remember we passed Bayou in this pack, I believe, Tilt City. But that's what I mean by, like, Overgrown Tomb or... Basically, any land that is a duel that doesn't have a big cost, like, coming to play top, is something we're interested in at this point. Quadskellion. I must have told you they dropped off yesterday and today. Oh. I don't know. I'm going to have to ask Luis about it, Marky. I thought you were asking a blanketed question. I didn't know you sent something. I'll have to ask him. He might know. I've been like on mono work control over the last 2 days, so I haven't even checked packages. But thank you if you sent something to Jules. That's very sweet of you. Look at her. She's right here. Hi, Jules. Hi, cutie. Wooded Foothills is potentially gets to fetch a blue-black duel. I feel like we have a lot of playables. Hi, Shadow. It's good to see you. Welcome. What do we think we take, chat? Do we just take Wooded Foothills on spec? If we manage to get an Overgrown Tomb, taking this Wooded Foothills will be, like, incredible. Also, if we get a... Hold on. Do we have a Stomping Ground? We have a Taiga. So if we play Taiga... Do we want to play Taiga? That's a question. It is a green source that technically also plays Rakdos Cackler. That's, like, a little sketchy. What's going on, Jules? She's a scratchy dog. I like Woe Strider. Woe Strider's pretty good. Hey, Lucas. Welcome. Wooded Foothills can fetch a UB duel. Wooded Foothills could potentially fetch a UB duel if we had one. Yeah, Woe Strider. What is this deck doing? This is a, like, stompy deck, kind of. Ooze is good. Ooze is also good. Whenever Orin Reef Ooze attacks, put a +1/+1 counter on each attacking creature with a +1/+1 counter on it. Yeah. I actually think there's a chance that Orin Reef Ooze is a little bit better. We have a lot of things that do get counters on them. Ways to get counters on stuff. It can, like, really snowball with Drana. Plus, we have things like Long Tusk Cup, Barg Hide Troll. This gets counters, right? Yeah, this gets +1/+1 counter. This instantly comes in with counters. Yeah, so I think I will take this. Can easily splash Grimgully at this point. I don't know if it's easy. We'll see. We'll see. We'll see. I don't think we want a Fertilid. Don't think we want... What about Endless One? Oh my god. Goblin Bomb is back in here. No, never again, Gatekeeper. Never. I have sworn off Goblin Bomb. One time was all I needed. Yeah, I think I'll take Endless One. Play it as a 3-drop or something. Play it as a 4-drop, maybe. Just a flexible card. I think the Steelbane is going to be a sideboard card for now. Do we have any more ways of putting counters on stuff? Hey, Kula Diego! It's been a while! How you been? How's life? Temple Garden, which is fetchable by Wooded Foothills, but it doesn't accomplish anything. Malefic Scythe gets +1/+1, but they're sold counters, so that it doesn't actually, like, super help. Yeah, hey, Firefly. We're doing well. How are you doing? Angrath could be interesting in this deck. Yeah, I like it. Just give our stuff menace. Be able to, like, close out a game. What's up? College is up? College is cool. Enjoy college, man. It goes by really fast. I've been working all this time and you... I've been working all this time too, Kilo Diego. It's been a really busy couple weeks. It's been super busy. But, you know, can't complain. So this comes with a wither counter on it, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. I could see playing this. I just don't think that we really want to be spending time leveling up stuff. I could see taking Vampire Hexmage to put in the sideboard just for, like, a Planeswalker deck that we play against, potentially. Yeah, I think we're taking a sideboard card here, and I think it's Hexmage or Wickerbow Elder. And since we have the Steelbane Hydra, I think I'd rather take that. Because Steelbane Hydra basically does the same thing, right? Let me look at it. Here it is. Yeah, 3 mana, remove a counter from it, destroy target artifact or enchantment. So it's basically the same thing. Oh, hello, 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 hello. Hello, 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 hello. There's a lot of stuff here. It could be Marin, but I think it might just be Pelt Collector. Is it just Pelt Collector? I think so. Like, we are just a really aggressive deck. And Marin is kind of slow. Yeah, exactly, Gatekeeper. I used to have Marin of Clan Nel'Toth in my Vintage Cube. And I ended up having to take her out because I think she's much better in something like a Legacy Cube. Vintage is too fast. Oh, hold on. My Julita is gone. I like the Shade. The Shade is really strong. It's a good recursive threat. Is that better than Varul's? I think so. Because this deck is going to allow us to go maybe like 1-drop, 2-drop, 2-drop, 1-drop. Or like 1-drop, 2-drop, 3-drop. Like that's how... That's how good it's looking. Song is also nice catch-all removal. Yeah, I prefer not to play Song in these kinds of decks. I like this kind of removal much better. Though we aren't getting a ton of it. Boop, 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 boop. Guldra's Assassin, huh? Forgotten Ancient actually seems pretty good because this deck is playing a bunch of spells. But I feel like that's much better in like trying to go like long game sort of plan. Guldra's Assassin is too expensive for us to put into this deck, unfortunately. I don't think we want Surge. I can see that, Dokomoi. This feels like it is a cube very focused on creatures, which does change that equation a little bit. I'm going to take the Guldra's for the sideboard. Interesting. Blood Artist, huh? Is that better than the Wildborn Preserver? I think we do take the Blood Artist, even though it can't attack. It's a little awkward. Is that the new shit? I missed it. Yeah, this is... Let me show you, Smurfy. Where is it? It's like the one of the... What's it called? Secret Lairs? Who took Slowport Cutthroat over Blood Artist? That's true. They were both there, right? Thicket. Yeah, we can take the Thicket. I don't know if we're gonna play the red cards. TBH. Oh my god. I'll take a Goblin Bomb. Just to give it a forever home. Domri's Ambush is not bad, actually. Okay, so these two came back. We can take the Wicker Bow Elder for the sideboard. And this. Grumgully is very good in this deck. What would this look like if we put a Grumgully in there? Let's see. Let me move all these to the side for now. This is 27. All right, we have to do a little bit of deck building. Ooh, sorry. Whoa. Well, we have kind of four free red sources. Like, the Wooded Foothills is free. So is the Taiga. The thing with a Firelit Thicket is if you don't have green, it's actually a colorless land. We do have the Hissing Quagmire. So it does look like we could play the Grumgully. I do think it's quite good. Also, some of these lands also, the red lands. Like, the Taiga is a green source that plays Angrath, which is nice. So if we have to make cuts, I could see us cutting Chronomaton because it's kind of slow. Savage Swipe seems good. Pelt Collector seems good. Boppers looks good. Thoughtseize is good. Knight is good. Blood Chief's Thirst is good. Aether Poisoner looks okay. Blood Artist looks a little sketchy, I think. Emerald Bruiser looks fine. Skyclave is good. Long Tusk is good. Barkhide Troll is good. Legionnaire is a 2-drop. Spinethopter is also a 2-drop. How is the Spinethopter looking in this deck? Is it okay? It looks kind of crappy. It's just a 2/1 flyer for 2. I actually think it looks medium. So then Grumgully, Spike Feeder, Jadelight Ranger, Ooze, Nissa, and Drana look good. Bruiser seems worse to you. Let me see which Bruiser. Emerald Bruiser. It's a 3-1 attacker. I do agree that this does look better than Bruiser. So maybe we do that swap. Then Angrath this. Maybe we don't even want the Colonian Hydra. When it ETBs with 4+1/+1 counters on it, when it attacks double the number of counters on it. We could just try to be like the fastest deck in the West. I feel like we're trying a bit too hard to be hyper aggro. Hey, BK, sup? 16 lands submit. Is this a GB deck? I say, yeah, it is, BK. What do you think? What changes would you make? This is all the stuff I had kind of on. We could also consider playing the Domri's Ambush. Domri's Ambush is good. My deck looks pretty mid-range. Do I have a reason? Do you think it looks pretty mid-range? I think it's a really low curving deck. The only reason I really want the Cackler is for the Orin Reef Ooze. I think we aren't as fast as we'd like to be. If we want to try to go a little slower, we could get rid of Cackler, put back Domri's Ambush. Oh my god, Luis. Stop. We are not leashed to BK's rules about archetype. We're unleashed, baby. Yes, Molly knew exactly what I was going to We are on the same wavelength, Molly. So if we add Domri's Ambush back in, we could also cut something else and just add a Steelbane Hydra, and then we also have a creature that deals with enchantments, and then we're more of a mid-rangey, but like relatively aggressive deck. I could see that. Hydra doubles counters on all your creatures. Oh, really? Oh, it is on each creature you control. Yeah, then I think I kind of want to add Steelbane. Steelbane is an X Hydra BK that also can kill enchantments. So destroy target artifact or enchantment for 3 mana, you remove a counter from it. So it's something you can play like around here. You think Chronomaton might be better. The thing I don't like about Chronomaton is I feel like it's so like hungry for manas. This one is slow and small. Maybe it's this and then we make one more cut. Maybe we don't actually play the Ambush, just the Grumgully. And then we go Wooded Foothills, Taiga, Firelit Thicket, Hissing Quagmire, plus... none of that go up here. None of that go up here. None of that go up here. That puts us at 7, 8, 8, 9, 10 green sources, 5, 6. That's not enough green sources. No, the 2-1 flyer lose 2 is not great. I think I probably want to make a swap for that. Hold on, let me go down this and this. So that's 9 green sources plus 6, 7. It's really unfortunate that the Wooded Foothills doesn't get black. Our mana's not good. I could go up one swamp and actually just cut the Spine Thopter like that. I think I like that. BK, that deck you were making fun of me yesterday, we won our two matches today. And then you were making fun of that deck. You were saying it was just some BG Garbo stuff. So how could you? Yeah, the Red Splash is a little rough. I do think Grimgully is good, and it also casts Angrath. We'll find out. I don't know. It's a new cube. We're trying out different stuffs and things. The Red Splash is relatively free. Like, the only card that isn't free is the Thicket. Oh my god, BK, how could you? I sadly think this is more like the old BG Garbo than the last. This deck is looking a little loose. Just like moderately. I feel like if we just go fast, we will be fine. We have some cards that are pretty synergistic here. Like, our deck can get out the gates pretty quickly. We have a lot of cards with Phyrexian mana. It's like cheating a little bit. Yeah. You know, Yawgmoth was really good in our last deck. Yawgmoth single-handedly won us 2 games, I believe. One game that we absolutely couldn't have won without Yawg, and then one where it just, like, helped us get a lot of advantage. Some of the Sackpod stuff looked a little loose. BK, when did you become such a hater? My god, I'm gonna mulligan this hand. Oh my god, what's happening? No, mulligan again. Send back a swamp. Send back Grimgully? Because I could go like... oh my god. I can go forest into Kissing Quagmire into swamp, get another forest. Yeah. Alright, bye-bye, Grimgully. This is awful, though. Sparring Construct, I accept. That might work someday. Send back the second land. I think I'd rather have... Oh my god. Okay, well, they had a sick draw. I don't even know if we could do anything about that, to be honest. I guess we're taking another 5. We do have either Poisoner, yes. That's kind of our out, I think. It's hard to beat, like, Sparring Construct and Soul Artifact. Do we have anything else? Oh, I do have my Dude Land. That's right. The Hissing Quagmire maybe can block at some point. Give up Temptation. Sack Cave of Temptation, put 2 plus 1 plus 1 counter to target creature, activate this ability only at the time you would cast a sorcery. Okay. Okay. So, let's go Nissa. I will. When I activate it, I'll bust out some gooby hissing noises. You better believe it, BK. I would like to fetch a forest. Gimme. I would like to grow that thing. So, am I just jumping? I could just take another 5 from the Sparring Construct and then just try to line it up so that I like next turn I can just activate it, which means I could just take another 5 and attack with Pelt Collector this turn. I don't know, this is a little sketchy. Oh, that's right. Bloodchief Thirst would also do the thing. No blocks. All right, we're down to 5. Is that true? Do you think that's true? That would be very funny. I'm gonna play another one of these. So this is, when does it flip? 7 or more lands. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I want to make sure I leave something back just so if they have a removal spell, like they can't attack anymore. It seems to me like... which one's more valuable? We're really far from this Nissa proccing. You know what? I'm just gonna chill. Christenator! Oh, thank you so much for the 31. I appreciate that. Welcome back, friend. How are you doing, Christenator? Hope you're having a good one. So they cracked the witching well. Sure, they jubated my thing. No Angrath, Jaswan. We can't play Angrath here. They might not attack. They did attack. So yeah, I promised BK I would do that. Oh, is this gonna work? They forgot about it. Tap X on tap, create artifacts you control. Look at the top X card of your library. Put one of them into your hand and the rest on the bottom of your library in any order. Cool. Nice. Oh, and now we get to swipe this thing too, don't we? With Anissa. So we get to go... hold on. Let me play my land. Swipe you to you. Swing! Alright, I think we're back in this. Are we back in this? Yeah, Nissa having two powerful swipe there was pretty important. I think they just didn't see my Hissing Quagmire. Because they used Blood Chief's Thirst to kill my Pelt Collector. This draws them a card. Yep. So it enters the battlefield with 3+1/+1 counters if you didn't cast it from your hand. They did, though. Okay. They also have a Cranial Plating. Mmm. Hello. Oh, that's true, Time Twister. Yup. I also miss my opponents having creature lands all the time. I don't really care about that very much. So, I do want to hit with a Cub, and then I can probably leave back a Nissa and a Drana. Or even just, like, play Angrath and make a... an Amaz? Maybe Angrath and Amaz is best. And then it can hit with the Cub. Because starting to get counters on this is pretty good. Maybe we're trying to. Yeah, Long Tusk Cub with Menace is pretty nice. So you can activate it. Oh! I can't believe we won that game. So they do seem to be an artifact heavy deck. That makes me feel like we want the Steelbane Boy. It's slow, but I think being able to kill their artifact stuff is pretty meaningful. Like, they seem to be on Cranial Platings. They had a bunch of stuff. Yeah, Wicker Bow Elder looks good against them too. So if we bring Wicker Bow and Steelbane, we can take out... just, what are the crappy ones? The Aether Poisoner... actually, maybe the Skyclave Shade isn't great here. They seem pretty aggressive. So if we play the Shade, like if we keep a hand with a Shade and we can't block, that's not great for us. It's a really good ability, though. Does Hydra activate at instant speed? Let me look at it. Yep, assuming you have the mana and the counters for it. Maybe Spike Feeder is looking a little loose here. And... there was, BK. There absolutely was. And the Kissing Quagmire took down the other thing and we won the... the match because of it. So all is good in the world, BK. Nissa got to savagely swipe one of their creatures and then they just didn't have anything left and they lost. Hey, Chris, welcome on in. How you doing? Might take out the Grumgully. I don't know. I'm going to take the Shade. I feel like the Shade is not looking good in this matchup. I think we want more creatures that can block, not creatures that are attack for a lot and can't block. Could let the other Hydra go. I could see that as well. Let's keep this one. This looks pretty good. Wooded Foothills does not get black, unfortunately. Sure, they got a Witching Well. This is a pretty good hand. Ooh, woo! Let's lead on this. So we can go boppers into Nissa. It's a little awkward because we kind of want to play the... Oh, hello. Whenever Skyship Plunderer deals combat damage to player for each kind of counter on target permanent or player, give that permanent or player another counter of that kind. So... does feel like we just want to play Nissa here. Is that right? Yeah, that's right. Little awkward for Pelty Boy, but what can you do? Chromatic Star into Crack It? Sure. They hit, we don't block. Sounds good. They don't really proliferate anything. Ooh, Knight of Ebon Legion. So we could go Pelt Collector Knight. We could also just go Wicker Bow Elder. And then we can't activate it, but it is huge. It's like 4/4. I kind of want to make sure that we get this Pelt Collector down. I don't know. That seems important to me. Let me just go Pelt Collector. Knight of Ebon Legion. And whatever. Just a forest. And then we can send with you. No black mana. Ah, we got the birds. The burbs of paradise. I just feel like getting this Pelt Collector going and then pumping it up with Wicker Bow Elder is pretty good. Oh, man. That's a card, for sure. We could Blood Chief's Thirst the Skyship Plunderer just so that because they're tapped out this turn, then play a Wicker Bow Elder, which also grows this, and then we can attack with these two. If they take a trade, I think we'd be fine with it. What if Ohio thins a little bit? Yeah, I don't even know if we like really care about that. I think it's more about how do we want to use this Blood Chief Search, given that there's a Glen in play. I think maybe we just want to pressure them so that the Glen is forced to block eventually. So maybe we don't even play the Blood Chief Search. Maybe we... I'm just worried that they're going to get counters on something and then the Skyship Plunderer is going to be able to start proliferating. So maybe it is actually okay to just go ahead and kill that. And play a Wicker Bow Elder and do this. That grows that guy and hit with these two. And we're okay with a trade here. Then next turn, if they don't... oh, look, they're going for a trade. Nice. I was going to say, next turn, if they don't crack the Witching Well, we can use the Wicker Bow Elder to kill it. Well, we can kill that. Oh, shoot. That is sketchy AF for us. Oh my god. This is with three. So we could actually attack with a bunch of stuff. Yeah, we can debate it. Exactly, Time Twister. I was on the same plan too. So let me play a forest. And we're going to attack with this, this, and this. They didn't do it. So then we're hitting for 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah. I like it. Yo, Rixta! How you doing? I'm doing awesome. How are you? We are about to win, I think. Yeah, that was a really unfortunate spot for them. Like, if they had one more artifact, the Edge Champion would have probably soloed our team, but they just weren't in a spot to actually stop us from getting there. Edge Champion. Hmm. How are you doing, Rix? It's good to see you. If they don't trade Knight, get a counter. Yeah, for sure, for sure. For sure. You're doing well. I like it. Have you had a chance to play this cube at all? Chat, have you had a chance to play this cube yet? It's pretty fun. I know. BG wins again. Kevin Bacon bits. Oh, no. We've been getting some really heinous... Ugh. Do we keep this? We've been having some really heinous draws. You're just happy you know how to spell debate now? You love to see it. Like, we could start just pumping up the Chronomaton, but this is... Wait, are we on the show game log? I'm playing first. I think we have to go to 5. Okay, this is better. Put away a... So how's this gonna go? We're gonna go turn 1, Knight. Turn 2, Poisoner. Turn 3, hopefully Nissa. You think you'd keep? You would have kept the last one? It does feel like Thoughtseize is not going to happen with just one black mana. So that one can definitely go. The question is whether we want to send back Savage Swipe or Nissa. Because we're definitely going to go turn 1, turn 2, keep attacking, make tokens. And then this gets us another land. So maybe it's just a Savage Swipe like this. We've had some really bad mulls. It was Cobalt. We were on the play, though. That's part of the reason I was scared of keeping that hand. Ooh. That's good. That's good. I like it. That's true, BK. I don't know. The fact that we were on the play made me, like, pretty scared to keep that hand. I think if I were in the... You agree with them all? I think if I were on the draw, I would have kept it, for sure. Yeah, but even if the 5 ended up better than the 6, most of the time your 5 ends up a lot worse than your... What is that? Can't block. At the beginning of your upkeep, put a +1/+1 counter and you lose 1 life. Weird card. Well, that's good against my Death Toucher. Oh, woo! Yeah, so we're gonna wanna... Oh, this doesn't get black. Bummer. Yeah, I remember that card too. I think we'd rather just play Nissa over pumping up the Knight. So let me just go ahead and attack with both. Since it can't block, it's not that big a deal. I would like to use this to make a thingy. And then crack this to get a Taiga and play a Nissa. Next turn we can start pumping up the Knight. So my Aether Poisoner unfortunately doesn't make more stuffs, huh? Colony was cool because it was easy to give evasion. Here it's block me. Yeah, for sure. You love the nostalgia from seeing some of the limited cards you don't see anywhere else now. Yeah! What set was this even in? I remember playing... It was... Was this Kaladesh? I can't remember. It was in like a Kaladesh adjacent set. It wasn't Kaladesh. Okay. Yeah, it was Kaladesh. Got it. I like that cube lets you highlight these old cards. Like cards that you really wouldn't... That card is not good enough to be in almost any cube, but I guess in the counters cube, like, you can play Firework Colony or Fretwork Colony, whatever it's called. Oh, wait, I got a message. Yo! Thank you. I appreciate that. Good luck. Have fun. Enoch Bunkin. And it can't outlast. It could try to block some stuffs. Has first strike, huh? Because it already has a counter. I will not be blocking that. We're going to try to race that thing if we can. Okay. I think it might be better for us to pump up the Knight of Ebon Legion over playing the Skyclave Shade. I'm not sure. Alright, let me play a forest and attack with everybody. Yeah, it kind of depends on what they do, because if they put it in front of my knight, I have to pump it. Okay. So I will actually just play the shade. Alright, this fretwork colony is doing some work. We need to get a second black source for this Drana. But at least this still can threaten to pump. Oh no, that even is going to get them a land. Shame. It has first strike, so my Aether Poisoner can't attack, the Servo can't attack, and the Skyclave Shade can't attack. My Knight can attack, though. Is doing some fret work. Oh no, they have something else they can do. Oh shoot. Oh, holy shit, we can't beat that. They're about to gain 10 life. Yep, they got us good. Well, that was the tech. So, this is kind of funny. If we copy their Knight of the White Orchid. Oh, no. This is Search the Library for a Plains card. I can't actually fetch a Plains, unfortunately. So, that doesn't work the way I wanted to. I still think we want to play the Metamorph here, though. Because, like, if they attack with Fretwork Colony, I can just block with Aether Poisoner and then we're done with that. And then Knight of Ebon Legion can pump against the Knight of the White Orchid. Maybe you want a second Aether Poisoner? It's possible. Or we could slow roll the Metamorph until we have... Yeah, I actually think we should just slow roll here. Can I hit for four and play a second knight? I think it's better for me to try to defend against the Knight of the White Orchid, because if I attack, I'm not gonna hit for four. If I hit for four, I no longer can play Metamorph. So it doesn't really work out very well. That's a shame. Yeah, for sure, Howell. We're in a tough spot, like, no matter which way we cut it, unfortunately. Yeah, that's the right attack. Can't block. That was really good. So... So we can just kill the Knight of the White Orchid and maybe make another Phyrexian Metamorph, and then we have two things that can block the Fretwork Colony. That sounds good. We can go cast that, just straight up kill it. And then, if we copy the Aetherwork Poisoner, we can attack with this Poisoner to make another Servo. And then plus we'll have a Death Toucher left back. So yeah, we're in a like pretty bad spot in GL. They have mullets pretty bad. I think we're in a point in this game where we can't really play around most stuff, so we shouldn't. Yeah, we just don't like have an answer to that. Just hopped in. What's a Proliferate cube? Mr. Panda Gaming. It's a new cube that's out right now on Magic Online. And it's Emma Handy's Proliferate cube. It's part of the Cube Spotlight series. And we've been checking it out yesterday and today. It's been really fun so far. I would recommend it. Oh, hello. They knew what I was going to do. I would like to use a path. Get a black source. That was rough. So one of their cards was path. The problem is we can't really block the shade. I think it's servo. Yeah, I kind of think so too. The reason we can't do that is because if I copy the shade can't block and then we just die. So I'm going to leave the metamorph to die, sadly. Man, that ordeal of Heliod just really, really, really ruined us. Yeah, I might not let it through this time and then never let it through again. I think that might be the plan. I'm going to have to leave a servo back and then Drana's going to have to start doing some work. Oh, hello. Does Nissa help? It's only until end of turn. It's still a land. If I play Nissa, maybe I can try to erase them. Like, I can leave back two servos and then hit for six, puts them down to nine. I think you Drana this turn and maybe have lethal next turn. I could see that too. So if I just go play Drana. Drana does hit harder because it's putting three counters already on these plus Drana herself. And then we want to attack with a shade. Let me do some math real quick. So if we hit them for three, they go down to 12. I want to leave two back just to play it safe so I don't have to jump with Drana if something goes wrong. The next turn I hit, I put them to 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, plus Nissa should be lethal. So yeah, I can just hit with Shade here. I just want to make sure we don't, like, juke ourselves. Oh, that's true. They're also taking the damage from the fretwork colony. That is true. I do have to chump with one of my servos, which does change my Drana math. Oh, shoot. Plus one for each other creature you control with a plus one counter on it. And they can put plus one counters on it. Oh, no. That's really bad for me. Because that doesn't let me attack. Removal spell! Hi, lady! Lady, how are you? I'm losing! I am losing! High Sentinels is going to seal the deal, unfortunately. Nissa animate attack with Shade plus land and second main landfall to play Shade again. Are we just dead? What's our plan? Just chump chump? At this point, it's too late. I already played my land. I was just thinking of trying no big deal, just attack with land. I mean, I can try. Send in a swamp, I guess. I would like to use the ability. Basically send with these two and leave the other two back to block. Awful. And then we have chump chump. Man, them pathing are... Okay, yeah, that makes sense. They're at 7. Hope everybody had a good Friday Eve. Oh my gosh, Friday Eve. How was your day at work, lady? It's really good to see you. You wouldn't have sent shade this time. Oh, we're dubs. They have Banishing Light, so we could bring a Steelbane Hydra. I actually think we want the Wickerbow Elder. That sounds better. Yeah, I mean, it's fine. We multi-5 that game. That was a good run, considering all things considered. Either Poison or Shade. The Shade still seems good. Nice! That sounds awesome, Lunrail. That sounds like a fun weekend. Or a fun Thursday evening. Sounds good, Copper. Have a good one. I guess I could have made it so that we could have attacked the following turn. I don't know. That Shade wasn't doing a whole lot. What else do we cut? The Chronomaton seems kind of slow to me. Oh, that's nice, lady. How am I? We've had a kind of like hectic project we've been doing this week for CFB, so kind of stressed out, not gonna lie. I'm happy to be here with the stream, though. That's cool. I guess I'll keep this. It's a super slow hand. Like, we can lead on this. We want to lead with Grumgully and then get an extra counter on the Spike Feeder. Wait, what's exciting for Ryan? Started a fad people putting on... Oh, that's so cool, Ryan. You love to see it. We might as well play the Thicket. This gets Taiga. I guess I don't want to draw more land, so maybe getting Taiga off of this is not bad. That's funny, Lunrail. Zulaport Cutthroat. Okay. So, what does this do? Put a +1/+1 counter on it. Remove a counter from it. Deals X damage to target. That card does not seem very good. Playing Thicket is worse from a quality of life perspective. You make a very good point. Okay, time for some Grumgullies. Okay, I hope this Grumgully delivers to us. Colonian Hydra can come in a little bit. No! Okay, we brought a bunch of, like, enchantment removal stuff, but that sucks. That's too bad. Spike Feeder is gonna be able to fight something here. Oh, that might be even better. I think maybe we just play Nissa and start attacking them with a menace creatures. Like, they have to kind of attack Nissa because they're going to hit me for another 2, and that's not that good. And then next turn I can play Colonian Hydra and then just jam. Is that better than playing Spike Feeder and fighting a Zulaport Cutthroat? Oh, we could Nissa animate fight afterward too. That's true. I think I'm just going to go Firelit Thicket, and then this is going to make green, green. And then this makes black, and this. And I'll animate the forest. Yes. And then I'll just attack. Spike Feeder into Hydra is nice. It's true. I just feel like this is much better than, like, I don't know. I don't really know what we get from playing Spike Feeder and the Savage Swiping to kill the Cutthroat. It's not that good, I don't think. Oh. We are absolutely gonna want to play Colonian Hydra and... fight that thing. Or just kill it. So if I play... Swamp, play Hydra, animate forest, hit... Oh, no, I can't hit because I really want to fight Savage Swipe the High Sentinels between Colonian Hydra and High Sentinels, which leaves my Hydra back. I could also go Spike Feeder. Spike Feeder, and then it's going to be a 2-2. Fight it with Savage Swipe to the High Sentinels. And your Hydra fight. Yeah, that's what I was thinking, too, Gatekeeper. I don't know if that's worth it. I think I'd rather just play the Hydra. I think getting Hydra down is good. And then we animate a forest. And a swipe. Choose target creature you control, creature you don't control, and pay that. Yeah, I'm killing the Sentinel, BK. I can't attack with a forest. I had a separate play where I could have played Spike Feeder, Thirst this thing, then swipe that guy. But I think I'd rather get the Hydra down. It seems more useful to me. And then they have to deal with this Hydra. This Hydra's going to start going ham. I like your play. I like getting Hydra down too. Yeah, I think it's better to just get Hydra down here. I'm not totally sure though. Yeah, Hydra. I remember this card was like slightly played in Standard for a while. It just does get out of control. You have to attack with it is a problem. It's pretty good once you do. Pretty good once you do. I'm sad that we didn't get to play the Spike Feeder with an extra counter with a Grumgully. We did bring some of the enchantment removal stuff, so we might still draw that. Pre-combat Spike Feeder. Oh, yeah, because it just double... It's not even attacking, right? Whenever Colonian Hydra attacks, double number of +1/+1 counters on each creature you control. Yeah, so we'll definitely play the Spike Feeder pre-combat, then hit. I know, we were robbed of value. It feels bad, man. How are you, Ungno? It's good to see you. Good old days when attacking was good. These days, it's not even good. These days, all you want to do is play Oko and play Uro and play Omnath. Do they have a kill spell from my Colonian Hydra? We didn't see that much stuff that kills it. We saw Banishing Light last game. What the fuck is this? Whenever Dusk Urchin's attacks or blocks, put a -1/-1 counter on it. Whenever it dies, draw a card for each -1/-1 counter on it. It starts as a 4/3. Okay. Can't attack or block, remove a counter from... Okay, so we can remove them eventually. Unfortunate. They're both attacking Manissa. Can't block. Four task counters on it, huh? Doing well off tomorrow and every Friday until 2021. Dang, Ungno, that's sick. That's super cool. Convert a mana cost 2 or less. I mean, we could just feed her and kill the 3-drop with Nissa for mana. Do I have enough to do that? I do. I like it, BK. That is a good play. I need to make sure I leave double black. So this is feeder, and then I play that plus... Yep. That's a good play, BK. I like it. I was trying to see if I could make the... I couldn't figure it out, but you're a smart cookie. You figured it out. Untap you. I would like to use the ability. Then I have to cast this with kicker and go 1, 2, 3, 4... Yeah, you're a smart cookie. Cookie PhD for sure. Now I can also... I do want to do this at the end of the turn because I have gotten punished by, like, kill target tapped creature nonsense when you don't do it until on the turn. But now Spike Feeder can block for Nissa, and, I mean, they can figure out stuff with the Cruel Sadist and the Cutthroat, but then this is ticking down to eventually be able to attack. Oh shit. I'm not prepared for that. Are they gonna level it up? What's going on with Spike Feeder's power and toughness? It just looks weird. It's a 2-2, but it just looks bizarre. Yup. Here it comes. Yup. Oh, snap. Yeah, it's just hard to see slash read, etc. So is that level 3 now? Oof. Move task counter. Here we are just doing tasks. Barkhide Troll. That does... It enters with a +1/+1 counter on it. I could make it... Oh, I could move counters into the Barkhide Troll and give it like indestructible. Oh no, excuse me. It gets hexproof until end of turn. That's not as good as I thought it was. Shoot. Well, we could Nissa and send something if they'd have to double block. We can kill the other creature if they do. Like, we can kill a cutthroat or we can kill a sadist. Not great. Oh my god, Vader. That's pretty good. We have very few options here. Bark, hide, and send with a land. I kind of am thinking that that's our best play too. Which is unfortunate. Guess there's no reason to do any of the forests. We can just get in there. Should I use the thicket for troll? That's funny. First strike means no trade. No, menace means trade. Menace does mean trade. Oh, I could have moved a... Oh, I still can do that. Put a +1/+1 counter on Cruel Sadist. Can't we move two counters? I guess I fucked up because I could have assigned it a different way. I could have assigned student first and then put a counter on the swamp and then killed the student. Instead, I'm just going to kill the Cruel Sadist and I don't really have a choice here. Move one and it's fine. Is it? No, it's not. Isn't it just... Oh, I do need to move one. Hold on, you're right. I do need to move one. Yeah, killing student was the move for sure. I kind of beefed it. That was my bad. Alright, well... There goes the sadist and there goes the swamp. We don't really lose that much by losing the swamp is the one nice thing. Sure. And we can chump. If they end up double striking it, we can chump with a spike feeder. Then the hydra goes down to 2. Yeesh. We have a lot of answers to Student of Warfare too, so... What is that? Oh no, get out. All right, well, as it turns out, killing the Student of Warfare wouldn't have helped that much for what it's worth. If they attack, I'm not even blocking here. I thought they were gonna give it double strike. Yep. Are they coming at Nissa? I will let that happen. Another one. Okay, it's at 2. Oh no. Unfortunate. I guess we send another menace swamp at them. See what they do. Do we send the Barkhide troll too? We might. It's not very good unless we kill specifically the Luros. Yeah, I'll send with both of these. We're in a bad spot. Okay, they're just taking it. We kind of needed to block. Yeah, we kind of really do needed to block. We are not in good shape. Let me tick up with Nissa. We have a Hissing Quagmire that we can block with. And then the Colonian Hydra is actually close to getting free. Also, if we draw any of our enchantment removal stuff, I think we get the Grumgully back, which would be nice. I guess at this point, it might not do anything anymore. All right, here we go. It's leveling up. 5, 6, 7. All right, here we go. Sounds good, Riggs. Thanks for hanging out. I appreciate that. Sadist is back. Yo, Shadow, welcome. Oh, that's true. They can do that, can't they? Horrible. Yeah, I think the plan right now is to block with feeder and move a counter onto the Barkhide Thrall, maybe. Oh my god, hold on. They attacked with Lurus? Are you for real? And it made Hissing Quagmire. I did not expect this, but I am very happy about this outcome. So let's go to blocks, and then this can chump here, this can block there, and do we even want to move a counter or just gain life? Because that's definitely the blocks. Yeah, I think after this attack, we're in this game again. Remove a +1/+1 counter, gain 2, or move. Moving cost 2. Well, I have 2. I have the thicket and the quag. The question is whether or not we want to. We could put it on the Colonian Hydra and just try to go to town. Move counter, reanimate spike feeder. How are we reanimating? Oh, hand or graveyard with 2+1/+1 counters on it. Yeah. Yeah, that sounds good. Okay, so let's go remove a counter from here and put it on the Colonian Hydra. I think that's our best chance. I don't know why they attacked with the lures. That attack was bad. Okay, so we blocked, we traded, and then we took 3. And then we also removed the task counter on here. Okay, Colonian Hydra is back in action, baby. So if you straight up reanimate. Oh, we should play Jaylight Ranger first to see if we get a land. So that way, if we landfall, we can play Nissa without losing her. Let me actually use this like that. And one more. Boom, baby. How good is Angrath here? Not bad, but I run a land. Yes! Perfect. Amazing, 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 amazing. Okay, so now we just forest, tick up the Nissa, and then we -5. I would like to use the ability, get back the spike feeder, baby! Okay, we're back in this. Whew! This has been a really complicated game. So we're probably just jumping with Jade Light, and but the Colonian Hydra is free after this turn. So yeah, we are kind of doing it. Do we attack with anyone here? Who are we blocking with is the question. We're blocking with Jade Light Ranger, so we can probably hit with a Barkhide Troll. Yeah, that seems okay. Okay. All right. All right. All right. All right. All right. God, Colonian Hydra's just ready, baby. It's ready. The Mighty Linguini! Moosers, welcome back with a 32 months. Damn. Hype Moose! Oh yeah, Spike Feeder's gonna get thick AF. How are you, Moosers? It's good to see you. We're playing a super tight game right now. It's been really, really cool. And so it doubles the number, so this Spike Feeder is going to go ham. Oh no, get out. No, 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 not like this. No, 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 no. We worked so hard to get this going. Ah, now we might be losing again. You know, just out of spite, I'm going to free my Colonian Hydra from its tasks. It did a good job. It was a good boy. Bye-bye. You just played your last round of VML round robin. Holy moly, Moosers! That's so cool. I'm proud of you. That's amazing. Yeah, our clock is doing a little, is being like not amazing. Oh, hold on. This is attacking Nissa and this is coming at us. Well, we do have to block there probably. And they get to pay some life for the Adanto Vanguard. Oh, I am so sad. I'm so sad about our Colonian Hydra. So, Moosers, when does the top 8? Oh my god, BK. Hello. Whenever Orin Refus attacks, put a +1/+1 counter on each attacking creature with a +1/+1 counter on it. I mean, if we put a counter on the Barkai Troll plus Spike Feeder, technically we can double block the Student of Warfare. I don't know if that's worth it, but it's something. I also could just try to race at this point. Like, we're just doing so bad. You can double block without the counter. Well, I still think I want to put the counter here. How's the cube? It's been good. It's been good, Moosers. I've been enjoying it. Like, I think you can make... Oh, that's true. I can use that with the feeder. I think I'm going to send these two, and I'm going to leave back the Barkai Troll to maybe block that, plus this chump's there or something. I feel like we have to get aggressive. We're not going to win if we just sit here. Hi, my love.
I agree. You got to get aggressive.
You like it? You don't even know what's going on in this game.
Yeah, I in general agree.
Cool. I'm glad you agree with my blanketed statement. I've been playing a super interesting game where they had Lurus for a while, so I thought we were dead because I had a Colonian Hydra that was going to go off and they had a Heliod's Punishment on it, and they could have just kept replaying it.
Oh.
But they didn't. They didn't. They beefed it.
Hmm. This doesn't look so bad.
It looks mean.
You can get a bunch of life at any point.
I can. The feeder. That Student of Warfare is Megamorph, though. I think my plan is to put a counter on the Barkai Troll and just try to get that block down, plus maybe block an Anto Vanguard or something. Depends on where they attack. No, they really haven't, BK.
And BK stole my sign-off
earlier. Yeah, I heard you were the sign-off stealer, Luis.
No, BK stole my sign-off.
Mm-hmm.
Stealing around. He's trying to trick everyone.
This is attacking Nissa. This is attacking me. So I definitely... Oh, this is also attacking Nissa. Nah... Okay. There.
Gaby, I sent all the things with all the bits.
Did you? Oh my gosh, I'm so happy to hear that, my love. Uh, not jumping student, BK. What are you talking about? Did you not wanna... We just traded everything. I had different plans. I had plans to move the spike. Yeah, my plan was sweet, man. It was cool. My plan is to just attack them now until they die, hopefully. But yeah, my plans were chill AF. Or something. Really? I'm gonna assign him that way. I don't think my opponent has played the last couple turns very well, for what it's worth. Yep. Wow, Spike Feeder went the distance, man. Spike Feeder's a real one. This is a little 3-3. Battled against the Student of Warfare. I guess technically that was the Barkhide Troll. Oh my freaking god. It's okay. The land can go the distance. Yeah, so if we land and then move counters onto the land for two, as long as they don't have, like, path, we beat them? Is that right? That's better than freeing Grumgully or Colonian Hydra, right? They had path last game. We could play it slow. I'd play it slow. If we play it slow, what do we want to do? We can go Wicker Bow Elder and then try to free the Colonian Hydra for when they attack. So we could just send the Nissa land plus Wicker Bow Elder. Yeah, and get back the Hydra. But I can do that at instant speed too. Yeah, that sounds good. So I can go 1, 2. Don't worry about the clock. We're fine on the clock, Zer. Yeah, I just want to make sure we have enough green left back. Yeah, but we're up a game Cobalt, so we're Gucci. Yeah. So even though we have a minute, I think we're going to be fine. Yeah, exactly, BK. Don't worry. So we'll get the Hydra back. Their attacks won't be great. We're at 8, so we have like a good amount of life left. We have that Spike Feeder too. Kind of have to attack here, right? They ordered it, right? Beep boop. It's back, baby! That attack did not work out, and now we get to win the game of magic! Me too! I too have been dreaming of attacking with this Colonian Hydra for years! It's been years, man! It's been years, baby! We got there. Boom. Wait. Holy moly, I thought we were up a game. Ah! No, I thought we were up a game. Don't laugh at me, my love. Okay. All right. New plan. It was such a good match until we ran out of time. Rakdos Cackler in. Steelbane Hydra in. Oh my god, BK, I was so sure. That was our... Endless One's too slow. Get out. We're just going to go pedal to the metal. Steelbane is not as slow, but it just removes their enchantments, and they had so many, BK. So I think even, like, just having it as a... Oh, hold on. New plan. Hold on. Spinethopter, get in. Endless One, get in. Yeah, I'm just actually going to go big. Like, huge big. Remove Grumgully and remove these guys. That one is fine for Thin to win. And add another forest. Okay. Okay. Oh yeah, that's right. The taiga is used for the Keckler. We definitely keep that one in over a forest. But I don't want to play the fire lit thicket. Okay, here we go. I'm not gonna be looking at chat. We're just gonna try to go fast and furious. I was so sure we were up a game. Shoot. All right, I'm gonna keep this. Okay, so we're gonna go not that. Barkhide Troll, then Swamp Jade Light, then maybe get a land. Oh my god. This is Godspeed for sure. There's no way we're gonna get there. I have six. Why isn't it accepting my F6s? The fact that it's not accepting my F6s is really bad. All right. Ornery Foos might be better. No, actually, Jade Light is going to be better, I think. Sure. Yeah, I'm going to want to kill that thing, probs. Let's go. All can Blood Chief search that thing up. Graveyard, we want lands. No, we want lands still. Pack. Alright, so this has blocks on this, doesn't have blocks on this. We don't even have to Savage Swipe, we can just Blood Chief's Thirst. Potentially Ornreef Ooze and just pump up one of our things. High Sentinel sucks. Need another black source to deal with that. That doesn't quite work. Rats. Ugh, we don't have a... Damn! Ooze counter here. Yeah, and then we thirst on the... Do that. But I can't even, like, attack... Oh, yeah, I guess I can attack just you and you. And then next turn, maybe the Ornreef can attack. I could also, before combat, Savage Swipe with an Ornreef Ooze onto the High Sentinels if they haven't put on a counter because I can just eat it. If they have a removal spell, I can wicker bow. Or I can just endless one for three. Because this doubles, what does it do exactly? Plus one counter on each attacking creature. This can put a +1/+1 counter on target on itself, right? It fights? Shoot. Oh god, I have to attack here. Shoot. I should have fought the Kithian, probably. I just needed to make this attack because I'm going to die otherwise. I'll play the Wicker Bow Elder afterward. I guess depending on how they block, I might Savage Swipe. Swiping the Kithian is not great because it could just get indestructible. I guess it makes my ooze big enough to attack. We'll see. At least my other guys are big enough to attack through this. Like, they can put something in front of the Ornreef and then they can just play the Wicker Bow Elder. Sure. I accept. If they give it indestructible, I'm actually just gonna Savage Swipe probably. Yep. Oh no, we're not gonna get there. We have 2 seconds left, that's too bad. I I yielded through this turn. Ah! I yield through this turn. Yield through this turn. Damn. BK, I think if we'd gone for that kill in the last game, I would have won. I might have been able to win here. Because we could have, I guess we could have, I guess we wouldn't have won this turn. Kind of spent 30s last turn, didn't need to be that slow. So my F6 isn't working was part of it. Like even when I was yielding through the turn, I didn't know what your F6, F8 issues were this game. You lost a bunch of time there. I did. It wasn't, let me see. It's supposed to be set. Look, my okay, my pass, and my toggle pass are supposed to be ASD. But it just wasn't actually F6ing. Which one is pass until response? No, it's pass turn. Yeah, that's supposed to be S. That's my F6. It just doesn't, it didn't work. Honestly, my, yes, I use S for F6. I use ASD. Honestly, my keys, for Moto just don't work. Like, they're unreliable. And I don't know if that's the case for everybody else, but mine definitely are, like, pretty unreliable. If I press it multiple times, it's a cancel. No, it just doesn't work. Like, even if, you even saw it when I was, like, saying, like, yield until end the turn, and then my opponent was playing a Student of Warfriend, and it passed priority back to me. It just does that a lot. Mine does that, yours does that too, double exposure, yeah. So sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. I haven't changed the bindings at all, but whatever, it didn't work. I think people are about to show up at my place. Let me see. Yeah, I have to skedaddle. Sometimes I just have to press it really hard and it goes again. Or, hold on, I really just want to finish this so we can play Among Us tomorrow. I'll play the last round, so let me go use the restroom real quick. I'll be right back. Yo, I wanted to try to jam this game, but people just showed up at my house, so I gotta scoot. So what we're gonna do is, if you're watching this on YouTube, we're gonna fast forward into tomorrow, and then you'll see the last round. Hello everybody on YouTube, and welcome back. We're in round three here. It's been like 4 days or something. Oh no, Hippophant! Ian is killing you. No! Julie could use a nice 12-inch long Kong bone. She has a like a little pink Kong. She doesn't get as many treats in that thing anymore. We were doing a little bit more of that when she was first getting trained. And we needed more like activities in the house that would keep her busy for a bit. So she's like a pretty independent doggers now.
Hi, cutie. Hi.
Chat, let me tell you something that I think you'd enjoy hearing. A couple of things, actually. We started watching Avatar yesterday. I have seen it before, but Luis hasn't. And started rewatching it on Netflix. I know there's a few fans of the show here. Can we drop the Hydra stick? Yeah, The Last Airbender. The Last Airbender. It's such an amazing... No, not the movie. Even though I think that movie is quite good. No, The Last Airbender, the anime. Hi, little jelly bean. Now my opponents don't want to battle me. There are no fans of Avatar and Bossing say. Yeah, true. Hey, Jules. What you doing, girl?
You can kind of see her back there. Hi. You're coming back here? Julita. Hi.
Yeah, the actual movie for Avatar, not the blue Avatar. Like, The Last Airbender Avatar is awful. But the show is really good. Yeah, I really like Korra too, Dreamy. I don't like it as much as the OG Avatar, but I think it's really good. Also, we were talking about this yesterday. I think Legend of Korra is one of the only shows that manages to be in the same world as a different really, really successful show and not have that big of an impact from the original characters and still be a very good show. Like, it's very difficult to pull that off. Yeah, we will definitely go first. This looks okay. Savage Swipe doesn't do anything, but this buys us time, and then like both of these are pretty decent. Oh no, Deka. Internet's being the imposter for show. You think Cora has some really interesting themes, like... Yeah, no, I like the show. I don't think it's as good as the original Avatar. We just finished the Cimmerillion. I try to read the Cimmerillion and I give up. It was too boring. It read too much like a history book. Korra was far more interesting protagonist than Aang. I think Aang is more likable, but I think both shows are good. Anyway, we've been watching this. We started watching it yesterday, which was pretty cool. That was an excellent draw. Oh, interesting. Are they set in the same world, Ryan? I did not know that. I know Cheers, like, pretty well. I don't know Frasier very much. Yo, Synth! Welcome. Give me greenies. I can do that. Jules, come here. Oh my god, Synth, I don't have greenies. I just ran out. Holy moly. I can give her, if you want to give her, like, a bone, like, a teeth thing. I can give her a dentistics or a twisty. Old school Chris, thank you for the 15. I know. No greenies, dude. So this thing gets... I don't actually even care if this gets renowned. So I think I'm just going to play Drana. I know. I want to eat my toothbrush too. Whichever one she'd like more. She likes the dentist sticks quite a bit. Come here, Jules. Sit. Shake. Down. Up high. Good girl. All right, and she's off. So, I don't really want that thing to get big. I'm going to leave my squad back. Maybe I should have just hit with it. I just think if they have a way to kill one, they won't have a way to kill the second one. I know. Can you believe it? We're out of greenies in this economy. Horrible. You've been hardcore lurking recently. I want to hear how you're doing, Reej. Ooh, woo. They didn't do much. On each attacking creature you control. I think we probably can just savage swipe that thing. I saw some pictures of that Reach. That looks so cute. Oh, shit. That did not work out. Don't both have first strike? I just wanted it gone. I guess they would have killed my thing anyway. They just managed to 2-for-1 me, which was unfortunate. Oh, yeah, we might just end up thirsting that thing. It's 2 CMC, right? Yeah. Screw your thing in particular. You got a highly medium graphics card, but it's good enough to jam much Fallout. Oh, that's cool, Penguin. You love it. What kind of graphics card did you get? Yeah, Drowned got debated. I shouldn't have Savage Swipe. Maybe I should have just attacked first. Then they would have been forced to use the Lightning Helix, and then we would have known that. Oh, wow. That was not a huge deal. Also, I really would like to... Yeah, I really would like to... draw land. Yeah, this is a Proliferate cube, Luis. Welcome. How goes it? Luis, is the Q thing fixed in the lobby? Boo-doop-boo, that's bad. It's all good? Okay, cool. That's good. We're gonna have to take a hit from this thing again. I'm not really sure what our plan is. Oh, that's really cool, Scorpion. That's super exciting. Basically, Hexstar, we're always the crew, and our opponent is always the imposter. That's what's going on. Yeah, I needed a land. I think if I had a land a long time ago, we'd be in, like, pretty decent shape. Instead, we don't have a land. We get to attack with both. And also, like, Stormbreath Dragon deals us damage equal to cards in hand if it becomes monstrous, which is not really where you want to be at. That's... for shame. Yeah, I don't think we were going to get this one. Wooded Foothills does let us... Nissa and untap a swamp and have it attack. They're at 20, though. It seems very unlikely that we're going to get there. Yo, Fagan! Stormbreath is your favorite card. I like that card a lot, too, Ryan. I used to play it a lot. I used to play it in, like, Red-Green Monsters, I think it was. Okay, so time to go. So we can't actually attack with Knight of Ebon Legion, sadly. Oh, that's cool, Figgin. I'm glad you've been enjoying them. Stormbreath is your Neheb EDH deck, so good. Yeah, that card is good. That card is not too shabby. We're about to take a million damage. So this monster's just for 7. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Council's Judgment. Probably they voted for my Nissa. That's actually fine. We are forced to block here. Yeah, me too, Synth. I have seen that before, too. It's definitely a thing. Ooh, Janus, I love that. That's really cool. Okay, so we're taking a million damages. What's your new EDH deck? That sounds really cool. Oh, we might actually want to set it up, so... Oh, I guess if they just monsters next turn, we're dead. But we can set up to go Barkhide Troll plus Aether Poisoner. Omnath lands with new Omnath. I guess it is legal in EDH, huh? That's cool, Janice. I like it. Yeah, the om nom nom mon. Or whatever you want to call it. Oh, by the way, remember the Among Us game we're trying to schedule with a bunch of other like CFB podcasters? That's gonna go down this Friday, baby. Did they hit a land? They have not. And they also didn't animate Needle Spires, which is interesting. Okay, so they didn't attack. Oh, hello. Hello, 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 hello. I wonder what their last card is, because if we just Spike Feeder and... I just better put 2+1+1 counters on it, right? And so we could technically go up to 5 and then survive another hit potentially. But if they hit a land, we could just die on the spot. Because ideally, we'd block and then just remove counters on it. So, oh, I guess it's actually fine because this makes a 1-1. So let's attack with both. Hey, Gladiator! Welcome! The issue with Warhol types gives a lot of yelling games community. Yeah, I agree with that too. I think we have a good, like, non-yelly community. Okay, so we do want to go... Okay, so here's the thing. If we want to block both Needle Spires and a Danto Vanguard, we can't activate Spike Feeder. If we don't activate Spike Feeder, hold on. It deals damage to each opponent equal to the number of cards in that player's hand. Okay, so I can respond to the monstrous activation. Do people know how the wave of bans or the printing of so many cards that require bans have affected the health of a game? I think Hexstar, it's been generally bad for Magic. Like, I think a lot of people have had less... Like, a lot of people have just felt worse about all the formats because of it. Yeah, exactly, Slew. Mostly just that. Alright, well, we survived another hit from Stormbreath Dragon, so I guess we might be able to draw some removal or something. Seems Flying Reinforced 2. Discard this card, put 2+1/+1 counters on target creatures. Wait, why didn't they Oh, they can't reinforce Stormbreath Dragon because that's Pro White. Awkward. I just realized. I'm like, why didn't they just kill me? Yeah, that kind of has felt like the entire year, DC. Haste, whenever Slith Firewalker deals combat damage to a player, put a +1/+1 counter on it. Okay. Yo, Battle Ram, welcome. Like, I think it's better that they did all the bans that they did, but it also just kind of sucks that we're living in this world where this is the only answer. It's to just ban everything. Nah, we're just dead, chat. You really like the Magic FM take on organized play in the recent episode. Basically, that organized play is dead. We have no idea what's going on with a pro tour these days. I actually recommend it if you want it. Mashi and I talked about pro play because we've both like been really entrenched in this world for a really long time. Yeah, exactly, Ryan. Hey, Honk! Oh my gosh! It's really good to see you. Yo, yo. Playing Magic for change today. How are you doing? Hold on. I wanna VIP you, but I bet I can't because I have too many VIPs. Hold on. Yeah, I need to figure out. I need to do some cleanup is what I need to do. Yo, Molly, thank you so much for the shout out for Honk. You guys, Honk plays among us in our lobby, in our little MTG lobby, and she's great. So you should give her a follow. No, I really don't have too many VIPs. I'm loose with my VIP guidelines, clearly. Johnny, with a gift that's up to Honk. Thank you. So sweet, Johnny. I appreciate that. What's going on here? We are a Jund counters deck. We didn't really see. We saw some stuff where we could deal with some flyers, but not a lot of ways to deal with a Stormbreath Dragon exactly. We have some black cards that can take care of it for the most part. I think we don't have that much we can sideboard here. The Thopter doesn't really block Stormbreath. None of these other guys do either. We didn't see any enchantments for like Wicker Bow Elder, so I'm just going to send that back in. You aren't that loose, Gaby. I mean, not a VIP. Janice, I enjoyed it. Even if Caroline isn't here, it was good. I'm going to keep this. So we get to go Pelty C into what, Porcelain Legionnaire? Yeah, that doesn't seem too bad. I wish I were playing with AOC. Did you see that? This is so awkward because if I play Porcelain Legionnaire, I can't actually grow the Pelt Collector. Maybe it's better to play the Chronomaton into Spike Feeder into Porcelain Legionnaire? Emily. You're gonna have chat close while watching the AOC stream? I mean, it's gonna just be like, you know the streams where the chat just flies by? I'm pretty sure that's what it's gonna be like. Yeah, I kind of want to grow it too, so maybe... Maybe I'll just attack with Pelt Collector. Yeah, let me play Swamp in this. I just feel like we have so few resources. I don't really want to spew them off by only getting one grow on the Pelt Collector. Oh, is that true, Molly? Interesting. Okay, I don't very fire lit thicket. So that's one in tap. That's fine. I'll tap it next turn. It isn't Cuby Gooby. Hey, VK. Welcome. It is good to see you. How are you doing, my friend? I'm just going to hit with this. I don't want the Chronomaton to die. So you have Molly, BK, Lissy, and Slubers in the same lobby. Who do you suspect as being the imposter off the bat? No one, because... I guess the actual answer is whoever was last imposter, because I feel like the imposter algorithm on Among Us is kind of bad, so people end up getting imposter, like, in streaks. That's true. Sus bar is extremely sus. Oh, weird. Okay. Whenever enchanted creature attacks, put a +1/+1 counter on it. If it has three counters, sack it. When you sacrifice, it'll deal Purphoros. It deals 3 damage to any target. Okay. I kind of want to put the spike feeder in front of it. Like, if we put the Spike Fury in front of it and then don't... Like, they have to act first. Yeah, and once they've acted, we get to remove a counter and gain life. And then we get to do it again. Hi, UCF Knights! Welcome! How goes it? Ooh, Grumgully, eh? So, if I go... I could go Grumgully so the Porcelain Legionnaire enters with an extra counter on it. No, they never have, Molly, but I can't be convinced otherwise. I believe that the truth is out there, dude. I know it. I can feel it. I would hit the stupid Illuminati thing if Twitch hadn't sent out a big... Did you all hear about that? There was this like weird thing today where everybody got an email saying like, you're copyright infringing, bro. So this is going to go to 3 next turn. I'm not really blocking with Grumgully arm, so might as well just send with a Pelty Seam. Like, basically everyone... I believe these are John Avon. Yeah, they are. You can see it. It's tiny, but I can read it. Basically, everybody who streams on Twitch got a copyright notice today being like, DMCA takedown, you've infringed on copyright. Like, we're going to send the Gooby police after you. But... it was just a blanketed email, basically. It was actually kind of a mess because usually when you get a DMCA claim, you can counteract it. Like, you can claim, hey, I actually had the right to use it or whatever. And in this case, they didn't let you. Fight with fire on my Grumgully. Sure. Okay, it's a 5/3 now. I can't really block this. I'll just take it, I guess. DMCA on white. Just a DMCA takedown. Ooh, woo. Yeah, these lands are super cool. I think, which ones are these, Honk? These are the... I want to say these are the unstable... lands, but I am not 100% sure. Okay, let's start by doing some Jade Light Rangering. They are the unstable ones, got it. Yeah, that sounds cool. I think we can keep that on top. Okay, so since we're not gonna be attacking with... or since we can't pump up the Chronomaton, we should put them to 5, I think. Then we can take the 2 plus Porcelain Legionnaire. They can shoot one thing on attacks, but then they can't... oh, they just went straight into combat. The only EDH deck I kept selling after a collection was Kumin. I love Merfolk. Yeah! I used to play Merfolk in Modern. I was a huge fan of the Fish. It's true, Mephis. This is true. That's cool, DC. You know what tilts me? So Luis gave me these lands, a set of like 10 each as a gift for Christmas one time. Oh, we won the game. And I was so stoked. I was like, so cool. Look at my amazing lands. I was so happy with them. I take them to a Grand Prix and like three different opponents. Every time I played my lands, they're like, are those even Magic cards? They don't even look like Magic cards. Those lands are heinous. And I'm like, dude, I brought these lands. So stupid. Like, I put these lands in my deck for a reason. They're not lands that I got from the it was a limited GP2. Oh, people are, it's not even misogyny, DC, it's just stupid. It was like, yeah, look, make fun of my lands that, where are they? Hold on. I literally have them here. Look, man. They're so nice. You see that stuff? I'm so happy. I'm like, look at my cool lands. I can prepare because I also never bring lands to like a limited tournament. Look at how nice these are. And I got this whole like bag of them, this whole box. Yeah, how dare people do that? Honestly, how dare people be trying to be like, oh, they don't even look like Magic cards. I'm actually going to bring Wickerbow Elder. Seems like their creatures are pretty small, so Wickerbow Elder blocks. Also, if they have Ordeal of Purphoros, we can remove a counter to get rid of that. Instead, I will get rid of... who's small and crappy? Honestly, Chronomaton doesn't look super good here. It's too slow. Bring Savage Sweat back. You remember trying to pay big bucks for the Therese Nilsson full art of JF set? Yeah. Ooh. Alright, so this hand's good, and we have the Wickerbow Elder. That's kind of neat. Does it enter with a -1/-1 counter? Enters the battlefield with a -1/-1 counter. So it's not gonna grow the Pelt Collector if it's at 3, which is fine. Yeah, this hand's pretty good. So I guess we're going to go either Aether Poisoner or Legioner on 2. I'm not sure. Oh. This one dies at the end of... it inerts for... yeah, that's fine. So that's really funny. Oh, that's really good. Think just Porcelain Legionnaire. Yeah, me too, Dekka. I think people use energy cards mostly when Kaladesh was around to show energy, and also like if people are playing Storm and they want to show which color of mana they have. I've seen people use like fire energy for mountains, or like water for blue mana. Yeah, this is good kind of counters. I mean, honestly, an all counters cube would just be not fun as much as I like playing blue and cube, you know? Should try using grass and darkness energy cards in this deck instead. It was outlawed last year. Can you not use those as lands? You can't use them at all in GPs? That's a shame. Why do they care? Well, we missed on stuff, but we are attacking for a lot. That's fine. That actually grows my Pelt Collector. All right, so here's the move. This is what we're going to do. We're going to play the Long Tusk Cub first. Just because I think next turn if we brick on land, we can, like, this attacks for more. We can play the Aether Poisoner, get the 2 energy, immediately put counters on this to hit for 3. Hey, Team Kessig, our land situation is a little sus, not gonna lie. I agree. Our land situation is quite sus, NGL. Killed my Pelty boy. Alright, so we're gonna go all in on this Long Tusk Cub. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put counters here. Because I think just having a bigger thing is better. Actually, turn off auto yields. I think I want to just use the energy immediately. Righteous Fury! Thank you so much for the 9 months. Welcome back, friend. Have you and hear me out. Try voting your lands off the ship for being sus. I didn't want them off the ship. I need them on the ship. I'm actually just going to put this here because I don't want to give them a chance to respond to end of turn me putting a counter on Long Tusk Cub. I feel like there's like very few spells that they can actually kill at 4 versus 3. They really are, Mephis. I mean, they're at 15 and I have a 5 coming their way, including like a pretty hard to block creature, a death touch creature. And if they play something small, I can kill it with this. And almost any land unlocks my... Oh, I don't care about that at all. Do not care. Alright, that thing is gone. Their hand must be bad if they're just playing Hellspark Elementals. Show me what's up. Show me what you got. Why didn't they play literally anything here? This is weird. They made the worst play possible, I think. Last turn. Yeah, I do not like the Dragon Slayer. The Dragon Slayer is pretty annoying. It's the... I think it's the Hellkite. The Ordeal of Purpose, I'm not worried. The Freeblade, I'm not worried. This one's only annoying if they get to 5 and they flip it. Hold on, do I have a... No, I actually kind of agree with DC. I think the Dragon Slayer is better just because if they get one more land, they actually get to kill my Long Toast Cub for free, which sucks. We're kind of all in on this Cub right now. Can't pay, but I'm about to get a thing here. Yeah, that's the other thing too, is nothing in their hand deals with Cub right now. In fact, this thing's about to become a 5. Like, they can play Hellkite, and I can just turn this into a 5. So we would even just trade if that were the case. But can't I kill it with Thirst? I could, Mephis, but remember, the cost to Thirst is actually quite high. I wish we had a Tune with Aether. That would be so sweet. So we can still attack with both. We'll trade with a Hellkite, which is fine. Ooh, maybe they're ghosting and they see Thirst. They could be. I'm not really gonna be accusing my opponent of ghosting. Okay. I think I am down for... No, I do not want to do that. Because then all they have is a Topa and Freeblade and the Skarg and Hellkite, and that doesn't actually... Or sorry, and the Ordeal of Purphoros, which doesn't actually do that much. Even if the play is probably jam Freeblade and let that eat the Thirst, I don't understand this line at all. Oh, from them? I don't know why they were casting this thing. That thing just doesn't really do anything for them. Nope, not you. Okay. The one thing that's awkward for them is that if they do put it on the Topin Freeblade, the Ordeal of Purphoros, I have the Blood Chief's Thirst. They're not putting it on there. All right, hold on. I want to check my users in chat. One sec. Yeah, Ordeal doesn't do that much, but I am still surprised that they wouldn't do anything there. Like, we've seen multiple fives from them, right? It seems like you would want to commit to that. I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to kill this thing. Because we know that the other thing it has is an Ordeal of Purphoros, which we don't really care that much about. And their last card. Is this a spooky game? Not quite. I'm just gonna kill it. Hey, Darth Mewtwo, welcome. Alright, they're at 6. We've taken so much damage, even though they haven't, like, dealt us that much damage. Alright, Molly. Alright. You missed the old heroic decks for the ordeals. Those decks were fun. Sure, that's a 1-1. Not super scary. I would like to draw another... That does play the Wicker Bow Elder? I don't know. They blocked it? I could move a counter, but it's not worth it. I just want to play the Wicker Bow Elder. Can't even block. I mean, they decided to block my other thing. I didn't think it was worth it to move the Spike Feeder counter, because that plays into them having some sort of removal spell. The Wicker Bow Elder is pretty big, just as it is. They are actually forced to block and just chump here, fortunately for them. They have to block the Wicker Bow Elder,
ready
too.
Ready for possible snow this weekend?
Wait, are we getting snow this weekend on a rampage? I need to get my sprinklers winterized. Don't tell me it's true. Don't tell me it's true. Not like DS. Thursday has a chance of snow. All right, I think it's time for me to start finding somebody to winterize my sprinklers. Feels bad, man. I guess it is that time of year, huh? Ishara! Thank you so much for the 2 years! Oh, welcome back, friend. Appreciate you. It snowed in Wisconsin today. You got a couple inches. So we had a day where we had so much snow, but it was like a month ago. It was really weird. We got like 6 inches of snow or something. What does it mean to winterize sprinklers? Asking somebody who will never own a house or live in a place with snow. So, Dokomoi, basically sprinklers, because during the wintertime, they would have water go through them. During the wintertime, they freeze. So, if you don't, what winterizing them does is you get a machine that basically blows them all out and you shut down the sprinklers for the season. And then you don't bring it back up until things warm up again. Because if there's water in the sprinkler system when it's winter, it will freeze and burst the pipes, and then you basically fuck up the entire sprinkler system. And that's a really, really, really expensive thing to have happen. So the way you avoid that is when it's getting close to like the super cold season and when snow is starting to fall, you get somebody to come out and winterize your sprinklers. It's just a machine that basically blows out all the water that's in there, and then you shut down the water to the outside, and you do that until it's, you know, spring again. They changed the forecast since I looked. No snow on Saturday, but 4.5 inches on Saturday and Sunday? All right, hold on. Louise. We have to get the sprinklers winterized. It is time. Snow on Saturday and Sunday. You did. You made it in time for the next draft. All right, let me wrap up this VGO, and then we're going to do a new draft. If you're watching this on YouTube, thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed another Proliferate Cube Phantom Draft League, number 2. I like this cube quite a bit. I'm sad that I didn't draft it more. I've just been playing a lot of Among Us, so... You make your decisions, I guess. If you would like to try the Proliferate Cube, you're still like one day to try it, so you can definitely do that. Maybe they'll bring it back too, so who knows. It's a pretty cool... cube. Also, there is a deck list, or like there's a cube list for it. So if you want to like maybe try building something like that, you could also try something like that. Anyway, good luck, have fun, everybody. Thanks for watching, and I will see you all later. If you like this video, you can subscribe for more. And if you want to come say hi to us on the live stream, that's on twitch.tv/GabbySpartz. I stream every weekday in the afternoons, Mountain Times. See you later.